So, in case there is somebody here who doesn't know what the Samba 4 project entails, Samba 4 is basically a fully AD compatible domain controller. It can be a standalone domain controller, it can work in the same domain as a Windows Active Directory. I think they have reached up to 2012. I'm not sure anybody is working on 2016 at the moment, maybe they are. It supports all FISMO roles. You can manage your configuration by joining a Windows machine in the Samba domain, installing the administrative tools, and basically more or less manage it like a Windows controller. And of course, there is a Samba 2 command line. Since 2013, it has been released and has been successfully deployed in some businesses, in some schools, and in some government institutions in France. And some time ago, it was actually quite a lot of time ago, it was discussed that at that time, Samba 4, due to its use of a TDB database, it has a lot of restrictions. For example, because the TDB database was 32-bit, you could not have a database larger than 4 gigs, which proved a problem. And because it had a single process LDAP server, there really was a lot of space for improvement. So, so we decided that, even if I say so, we should use the best LDAP server out there, combine it with the capabilities that Samba has developed and basically create a very good LDAP server that is also compatible with Active Directory. Great. So a long time ago, around 2009, Samba used to have an OpenLDAP backend. But due to a lot of challenges in mapping the Active Directory specifics, such as differences in schema, different proprietary operations, it did not work very well and it was very difficult to support. So we decided to use this backend just as a stepping stone, because there were already automated tests for this. So basically use it as a stepping stone to develop the new project, which basically the goal is to port this functionality from Samba to OpenLDAP, so that OpenLDAP becomes the main LDAP service of the system, while you still need Samba 4 for things like the RPC protocol, DNS, Kerberos, and the like. So this is what we wanted to do. You have OpenLDAP running in the form of overlays, a lot of functionality of AD, running at the same on the same machine as Samba, which still maintains some capabilities that are necessary for the RPC processing, and basically depends on the protocol you use to access the system. It goes to a different service, OpenLDAP or Samba. So we started with this legacy OpenLDAP backend, and the plan was to just one by one take LDB modules from here, rewrite them as OpenLDAP overlays, test the system, make sure that what we've done works, and move on. But the problem is the Samba LDB modules. Maybe I should clarify a little bit. An LDB module in Samba is something that is actually quite similar to an OpenLDAP overlay, in that it provides handles for the LDAP operations. And you can implement it as a separate module and overlay on it on top of the database to implement new functionality. It's not that different in principle. So we thought, yeah, that would be great. But the thing is, as time went by, Samba modules became very interconnected. For example, they would pass each other messages to say, okay, skip access checks here because this is my internal request. And then, they started depending on that the previous module has already executed and has generated certain attributes, otherwise it don't work. So after trying for quite a while, we find out that we can't do it that way. We just couldn't turn off a module and just move it to OpenLDAP and test. It wouldn't work, although it took us quite a lot of trying. Where did we get? So at some point we did have inside OpenLDAP an overlay that generated Active Directory security descriptors. There's quite a complicated algorithm described in Microsoft documentation on how this is done. The module used some code from Samba libraries to do that. We got it to a point where it was more or less working, and also some other work was done which could not be tested or finished at the time. And we decided to try a different approach. We decided to use Samba to just provision our database and then start OpenLDAP and basically write the functionality from scratch. So we are able to test an individual module, an individual logical unit of functionality. So basically when after some manual testing, when we are happy with the result, then we can hopefully try to turn off the corresponding module in Samba and see and move on to the next module. But Samba does not stand still. The Samba team are something like at least 10 people working only on the AD side at any given time. And since the time we started this project, Samba has made huge improvements in its performance, which also led to changes in its architecture. For example, it now has an LMDB backend, which means it no longer has the 32-bit restriction. It switched to multiprocess model, which basically introduced lots of internal logs inside LDB. It changed the way it uses the T-event library, and as a result, we couldn't even use the provisioning. It wouldn't work. And we were kind of stuck. Where did we get with this approach? Well, as I demonstrated in 2017, we did have a pretty well working module, which basically, during provisioning, when Samba would basically create the CN equals schema partition, it will take the incoming operations and use them to generate a schema for OpenLDAP. So after provisioning is done, you actually, inside OpenLDAP, you have a Microsoft compatible schema. It also uses this information to generate some of the information that before that was hard-coded in a SwapDCOM file. Now it dynamically would create a member of configuration, some indexing, it would generate some object GUID attributes, the security identifiers, things like that. So, where are we now? Obviously, we can no longer use the provisioning script. I did try to fix it, proved very difficult. So this year, Andre and I went to Samba XP, and Andrew Bartlett of Catalyst, who is, you can say he's the lead developer on the Samba 4 side of things. Basically, he proposed, okay, why don't you just take the entire LDB stack, stick it in OpenLDAP, and use that as a base. And as after that, you know, try to refactor this stack so that modules become more and less independent. Basically, remove this configuration, this dependency, and after that, possibly develop the ability to wrap LDB modules inside an OpenLDAP overlay, so we can still use a lot of the code in Samba, but basically fit it more properly in an OpenLDAP architecture. So this is how we would start. You have Samba. Samba is still running its entire LDB module stack, interdependent, you know, like a whole mess of arrows there. And here is the exact same thing running in SwapD. How does that solve our provisioning problem? We do not actually need a separate provisioning interface for OpenLDAP because Samba can just provision the database. And OpenLDAP can use the same database. You just fire it up, it loads, because it will use Samba's LMDB backend, not OpenLDAP's. So just to make it clear, this is just how we start. This is not how we end. Step two would involve a lot of work in Samba. So We would basically work together with the Samba team to refactor all the modules to make them independent. This is something that would actually greatly benefit Samba itself. It would make Samba development much easier, and it would also allow us to move on to the next step, which is remove the entire LDAP stack from Samba, have it in SwapD, but this way we will be able to gradually start either replacing modules with overlays or encapsulate them in overlays. We'll be able to basically run benchmarks, run performance analysis, decide, okay, this module is too slow, we will rewrite it, or this module is too slow, but we can make it fast enough using Samba code. And the idea is that this approach will be very beneficial to both projects, because Samba will benefit hugely from any performance improvements we would make there. So there are some arrows missing, but the idea is that Samba will indeed remain interface for only the RPC protocols, and SwapD will handle LDAP traffic, and it will also contain in itself this AD implementation core that before was in LDB. So the question is, why now? We have discussed a similar idea a very long time ago, but it just wasn't feasible back then, because no improvements could actually be done while Samba still used the TDB backend, but we could do nothing with that. Samba itself has been, a lot of work has been put into it to increase performance, including rewriting a lot of the libraries to use a pre-allocated memory, so that we are less dependent on TALOC, which is Samba's memory allocation. So we could potentially switch to OpenLDAP's memory allocation model. And now that, for example, Andrew has a significant team working on that, and we'll be able to work together to do refactor in Samba, which will benefit both projects. Why do it at all? So we still think that this approach will lead to much better integration of both projects. And we also hope that it would lead to a much faster shipping date of a product that's actually usable by somebody. And the idea is, for example, if somebody writes a new Samba LDB module, it might take us quite a lot of time to rewrite it for an OpenLDAP overlay. If we are able to integrate LDB overlays, then we might be able to provide a temporary solution that includes the new functionality while we are getting around to catching up with them. So this way, users will be able to use new Samba features faster. Of course, but of course, we are going to have some problems with these guys. LDB is not and was never meant to be thread safe. Samba is not a thread-based application. We haven't yet tried to make it thread-safe, and we expect a lot of agents popping there. It's also a huge amount of code. Last time I checked, it was something like 50,000 lines of code, only the LDB modules without the accompanying libraries, and we have to be able to link all of that. Refactoring the LDB modules itself, it's going to also be quite the challenge, and a lot of stuff that we haven't even thought about. But we are crazy, so we're going to do it anyway. Any questions?
Are there any incompatibility issues between the, if you're talking about moving Samba code into the OpenLDAP, are there any incompatibility issues between, you know, code produced by the Samba project and the code, you know, then moving it into the OpenLDAP project? Are the licenses compatible?
At this point, they're not. We will be working with the Samba team to somehow resolve this issue.
And then the Samba developers, will they then join the OpenLDAP community? They'll be on the mailing list, or will the OpenLDAP be at Samba or do you know?
I'm not sure. I don't think a lot of them will, because a lot of them still think coding for OpenLDAP is very difficult. But that's exactly why it's going to be. Why. So I will be working on this project, Andre will be working on this project, and we will gain, on top of the expertise, we already have additional expertise and connection with the Samba team, so we could possibly handle that ourselves. Who knows what will happen in the future? If we have a running and working product, they might. Okay.
Yeah, thanks for this update. I mean, it seems it is a never-ending story, but maybe this will be the way to come to an end.
Yeah.
What you said, that the Samba people are willing to cooperate, is very good news.
Yeah.
And maybe at last a big friendship will come out of these two communities. Is there any timeline? So when can we expect to have a production-ready product?
I don't think we'll be able to even provide a timeline before step one, before we are sure that we can actually integrate LDB. So this is something that we have to do as an experiment, and if step one succeeds, then we can start planning for an actual release date. Yeah. And like you said, and like the this popular franchise, we do hope revolution is the last.
So, but it is clear that it's not only you who will be working on this project.
Not only me on the Simon side, at least, and from Samba, we do expect help in the refactoring of the LDB modules, or even help with advice, which is sometimes sorely needed. So,
and you mentioned an overlay, which is a ID schema. So we imagine that we use this overlay outside the Samba project, but to create an OpenLDAP proxy to a directory.
Well, it could be. No.
We already have. That's actually going to be my lightning talk tomorrow. So we already have a large segment of the Microsoft schema in the OpenLDAP repo, and so if you want to set up a proxy that talks to AD and understands the Microsoft schema, we can already do that.
Yeah, you transfer. Additionally, this module is basically meant to work specifically with a Samba provisioning system that feeds it a schema object one by one. So I don't know if it would fit any specific need. And you need Microsoft schema in file format somehow for this to work. Okay, thank you.